Okay, so good morning or good afternoon. Now, this is the answer key or the discussion of answers for our activities sa ating lesson installations. Also, pasensya if I could not meet you guys today because we are very busy with the paperwork right now sa accreditation. No? So, as much as I've wanted to meet you guys, ayoko naman itong i-delay na wala kayong gagawin. So, meron pa din kayong gagawin. So, you are expected to finish this, to understand this by week, before week 12, okay? Lalo na't wala tayong pasok on May 3, okay? So, ito ang inyong pagkakaabalahan, okay? Yan. So, ang tanong ko nung una is meron akong 10 kalapate at anong masasabi ninyo kung merong siyam na lalagyan, okay? So, in English, if there are 10 pigeons and only 9 pigeonholes, what can you conclude about this? So, napag-isipan niyo ba to? Sana gusto kong tanong sa recitation eh, pero hindi kaya ng ating oras ngayon. Okay? So, if there are 10 pigeons daw, ay 10 yung kalapate, siyam yung lalagyanan, siyam yung bahay nila, anong mangyayari? Okay, so, let's try to put the pigeons, or let's try to put itong mga kalapate dito sa kahon, no? Okay, so meron tayong 10. So, tigitigisa, huwag naman natin ipagsiksikan sa isang kahon lang itong 10 to. So, andito si number 1, number 2, number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Paano yung pang 10? Hindi naman natin pwedeng i-divide, no? Hindi naman pwedeng 10 divided by 9. Well, it's 1.111. Hindi naman natin pwedeng putulin yung isang kalapate, ano? Okay? So, what can we do is, pwedeng makishare yung pang 10 kahit saan dyan. Pwedeng dito siya makishare, no? Or, maaring ayaw nila dito sa lugar na to, pwedeng makishare itong si number 9 dito. Pwedeng tatlo silang magsama-sama dito, di ba? Okay? So, what can you conclude about it? Okay, so, ito yung prinsipyo behind that. Okay? So, we call this the pigeonhole principle. Now, the pigeonhole principle states that if N items are put into M containers, if N is greater than M, then at least one container must contain more than one item. Ulitin ko. Siguro in Tagalog, no? Kung meron daw 10 item at siyam na lalagyan at mas madami yung item kesa dun sa paglalagyan, then the containers must contain at least or merong laman to na hindi lang isa. Meron dito magdodoble, may magtitriple dito. Okay? So, pwedeng mag-share. Yun. Again, kung mas marami yung ilalagay sa lalagyan, edi mag-share tayo dyan. Yan yung pigeonhole principle. Now, what is the logic behind this? Anong ibig sabihin nito? Para saan ito? Okay? So, this is related to our lesson. Okay? If mas madami yung nandito natin sa domain kaysa sa range, merong mag-share. Okay, ayan. So, that is the purpose of this principle. And we will be using this later on. Okay? So, sagutan na muna natin yung ating mga activity. So, meron tayong activity number 1. Ayan, meron ako mga pinapahanap. Okay? So, una sa lahat, I have the given L equals 2, 4, 6, and I have 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay? So, this is the lesson on Cartesian products. Oops. Yan, lesson on Cartesian products. Ang gagawin lang natin, bibigay lang natin yung combinations nila. Okay? So, una muna yung L, kasunod yung M. Para organized, don't hesitate to draw or don't hesitate na i-point ninyo using your fingers. Kagayon to. 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Okay, organized. Tapos meron tayong 4, 0, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3. Tapos yun namang 6. 6, 0, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3. Okay? So, yan yung ating magiging answer. We have ordered pairs. Kailangan naka-parenthesis sila kasi sila yung mga mag-partner. Okay? Kumbaga, bawat mag-pares, bawat ordered pair ay considered one element. Okay? Isa, 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 and so on. Ngayon naman, sa M times L, so uunahin natin yung M saka yung L. So, meron tayo ditong 02, 04, 06. Okay? So, isulat ko na lang to. 02, 04, 06. Tapos, yun namang 12, 14, 16. Notice how systematized this is being done. Hindi yung kung ano na lang maisip ko na ay 6 06 14 32 tapos ano pa bang meron ako 26 ano pa bang wala 14. Hindi organized. So please keep it organized. Yung unahin niyo to 1. Unahin niyo tong nasa unahan. Tapos itong kasunod. Tapos ito 2 2 2 4 2, 6. And then, yung last. 3, 2. 3, 4. And 3, 6. Okay. Ito yung isa sa mahalagang matutunan ninyo. To make things organized. And meron kayong system. Okay? Systematize yung paraan ninyo ng pagsasagot. Hindi yung bara-bara. Okay? Sige, next na tayo. Now, when we see the two bars, I remember it's looking for the cardinality. Pag sinabing cardinality, ilan ang laman? So, what's the cardinality of set L? So, 1, 2, 3, tatlong laman. Set M, may apat. What's the cardinality of L times M? So, bilangin nyo to isa-isa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, meron tayo 12. Or kung ayaw nyo namang bilangin isa-isa yan, simple lang, multiply nyo. 3 times 4 or 4 times 3, 12. Okay? Sige, dito na tayo sa kasunod. We have set P equals 1, 2, 3, and so on until 100. And then Q equals A, B, C until Z. So, ito automatic naman. Counting numbers ito from 1 to 100. So, there are 100 numbers. Itong sa Q. Ma'am, ano ba to? English alphabet o Filipino alphabet? Ano bang alphabet ang may C at saka Z? So, syempre, it's the English alphabet. Right? Ito siguro kailangan tandaan ninyo kung ilang letters meron sa ating alphabet. So, in the English alphabet, we have 26 letters. Okay? O kahit isa-isa nyo pa, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Ay, pwede ninyong bilangin ganun. Basta tandaan na ninyo that there are 26 letters in the English alphabet. So, what's the cardinality of P times Q? Eh, hindi nyo naman kailangan isulat yung, ano, yung magiging relation na 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D. Until 100A, 100B. Hindi nyo na kailangan isulat yun dahil there are 2,600 of these pairs. Sobrang dami. Okay? So, that's it for activity 1. Now, we will proceed with our activity 2. Ayan. So, same given, pero nagbigay ako ng relation. Okay? So when we say r raised to negative 1, kukunin lang natin yung inverse, yung kabaliktaran. Okay, isi-switch lang natin to. Ang 2, 0 magiging 0, 2. Ang 4, 1 magiging 1, 4. 4, 3 magiging 3, 4. 2, 2 pa din. Okay? Now, tingnan natin kung ano yung mga ginamit na elements for the domain. Basically, ang domain ay lahat ng mga naunang number or naunang element. Although 2, 4, 6 ang meron tayo, hindi naman ginamit lahat. 2 at saka 4 lang ang ginamit. Okay? By the way, when you look for the domain and range, automatic dito kayo titingin, ha? Hindi dito sa R raised to negative 1. Okay. So, for the range, ang titingnan naman natin is yung mga second element na ginamit. So, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So, nagamit lahat. Okay, so that's it for the domain and range. Dito na tayo ngayon sa kasunod. Activity number 3. Okay, so same naman yung given, but I ask you to make a pictorial representation instead. Okay, so gawa muna tayo ng mano-manong directed graph. Ang sabi ko naman sa directed graph, you just have to write the elements. Okay, kahit saan yung positions nila, pero at again, if you want it more organized, then do it siguro in a circle, square, rectangle. Okay? So, try muna natin yung medyo pabilog. Tayo, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, walang 5, so 6. And then from the word itself, directed, meron siyang direction, kaya importante na may arrows. Okay? So, 2, 0. Una ang 2, papunta sa 0. Then, 4, 1. 4, 3. Then, 2, 2. So, mula 2, papunta sa 2. So, makikita niyo yung paikot na yan. Ay, kahit may araw, kahit wala. Okay, automatic naman yan. Pareho din naman yan eh. No? Now, I want to show you how it's being done dun sa ginamit natin na graphonline.ru. Sige, i-share ko lang to screen ko. Ayan. So, you can change the vertex enumeration kung saan kayo magsisimula. Pwedeng letters yan, pwedeng Greek, pwedeng Russian. Yan, Russian kasi itong gumawa nito eh. Edit tayo. Simula tayo sa 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Okay, hindi naman automatic 6 ang lumabas dito. So, you can actually right click then click rename. So, palitan lang natin yung name niya. Then, you can connect the vertices. Again, from 2, 0. Wala muna siyang weight. 4, 1. 4, 3, tapos 2, 2. Okay? Yan. So, if you think medyo confusing, tingnan, you can move these. Itong maganda sa technology eh, no? You can easily change the positions kung saan itong mga to. Okay? So, kung dito baka nakakalito, baka mapagkamalan yung weight ito, so you can change it into a different shape, pwedeng pa triangle. Ayan, so pwedeng pa-triangle na ganyan. Pwedeng isang hilera, pwedeng hindi sunod-sunod, kayong bahala dyan. No? Pwedeng gantong ginawa ninyo. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Pwedeng ganyan, no? So, it will differ from person to person. Okay, next time natin ayusin yan. Okay? So, another one is the matrix. Sige, yung matrix, yung isang pakita ko, no? Yung naka square braces. Square brackets, rather. Okay? So, again, dito daw sa rows, isusulat natin yung elements nito ng domain. So we have 2, 4, and 6. And then sa columns, yun namang range. So 0, 1, 2, and 3. Okay? Ang gagawin lang natin dito, lalagyan natin ng 1 yung combinations na available. So 2, 0, 4, 1, 4, 3, tapos 2, 2. Then the rest ay 0. Okay, pwede namang table kung gusto ninyo. This is another way to show the matrix. And the last one, the arrow diagram, itong pinakamadali. Gawa lang kayong dalawang bilog. Isulat ninyong elements. Then just draw arrows. 2, 0, 4, 1, 4, 3, and then 2, 2. Okay, that's it for activity 3. Now, dito naman tayo sa activity 4, sa types of relations. Ito medyo nakakalito, so make sure that you were able to write the samples or you were able to write your own understanding of the types of relations. Okay? I-recall lang natin. Sa reflexive relation, ang mahalaga, every element maps to itself. Bawat isang element merong ulit. Merong 1-1, may 2-2, may 3-3, may 5-5. Kung sakaling walang 5-5, that is not reflexive. Pero okay lang kung may dagdag yan. Okay? Symmetric relation, kung meron siyang kabaliktaran, kunyari meron tayong 3x, meron siyang kabaliktaran or meron siyang kapartner na x3. Okay? Kumbaga, ang symmetric, meron siyang ka-mirror. Sa transitive, tatandaan naman natin yung pattern na AB, BC, AC. Kahit meron pa ditong ibang dagdag na items. 0, 0. Kahit meron pa ditong 1, 2. Okay. Okay lang yon. And it's equivalent if it's reflexive, symmetric, and transitive at the same time. It's anti-symmetric naman kung halimbawa merong lumabas na symmetric. Okay. Merong lumabas na, kunyari, 1, 5. Meron siyang katumbas na 5, 1. Okay? So, automatically, this is anti-symmetric. Kasi, 1 is not equal to 5. Pero kung 1, 5 lang ang lumabas dyan, okay lang. This is still anti-symmetric. Okay? Kasi wala naman siyang kapartner eh. Okay? Sige, so let's try to answer activity 4. I think I've answered the first one for you. Una sa lahat, this is not reflexive dahil walang 2-2. Reflexive, remember, sabi, it should, every element maps to itself. Okay? So, it's not reflexive kasi walang 2-2. This is not symmetric kasi wala namang kapartner ito na 2-1. Yeah, kahit di nyo naman isulat ito, no? Okay, but I'm just writing it down so that you know bakit hindi siya symmetric. Kasi walang 2-1. Also, walang 3-1. So, kahit isang evidence lang, okay na, sapat na. Okay? This is transitive kasi meron tayong ma-observe na 1-1, 1-2, 1-2, 1-3, 3-3, 1-3, meron ito. And this is anti-symmetric kasi as you can see, wala namang kapartner itong mga to eh. No? So wala naman tayong masasabing 1 is not equal to 2. Okay? Wala naman siyang kapartner na symmetric. Wala siyang kasymmetric dito. So this is also anti-symmetric. Okay, so let's check if your answers are correct dito sa S. Now, is this reflexive? Meron bang 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3? Yes. So, this is reflexive. Symmetric ba? 1, 2, may kapartner na 2, 1. So, this is symmetric. Okay? Sensitive ba to? Tingnan natin. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, meron. Okay, automatic na, meron na, transitive na to. Now, is this anti-symmetric? Yung anti-symmetric ang baka nakakalito sa inyo. Okay, before you can answer this question, anti-symmetric ba siya? Tanongin nyo muna, is this symmetric? Yes, it is symmetric gawa nito. Okay, may 1, 2, may 2, 1. The question is 1 equal to 2? Hindi. So, this is not anti-symmetric. Okay? So, malinaw na ba ang anti-symmetric? So, I hope yes. Still, we have other examples naman later on. Right? Sige. Tignan naman tayo sa letter T. Is this reflexive? Anong kulang? Wala siyang 3, 3. Is this symmetric? Hindi. May kapartner ba ang 1, 2? Na 2, 1? Wala. May kapartner ba ang 2, 3? Wala siyang kapartner na 3, 2. So, this is not symmetric. Okay? Next, is this transitive? So, automatic, transitive siya dahil makikita naman natin meron tayong 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2. Ito na din yun. Huh? Pero, tingnan natin. Meron bang 2, 2, meron bang 2, 1? Wala siyang 2, 1, no? Wala siyang kapartner na ganun. 2, 2, 2, okay. 2, 2, 2, 3. 2, 3. Yan, meron pala, no? And 2, 3. Meron bang kapartner na 3 something? Parang wala. So, this is not transitive. Okay? So, itong kasunod, is this anti-symmetric? Well, wala namang kasymmetric ito. Wala rin kasymmetric ito. So, wala tayong masasabing 2 is not equal to 3. So, wala tayong masasabing ganyan. So, this is anti-symmetric. Okay? Ayan. Dito naman tayo sa kasunod. Sa universal relation. Okay? A times A. Now, binigay ko na din naman to, even though you have to solve this on your own. Automatic reflexive ito because of 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3. Symmetric din ba siya? Check natin. Ang 1, 2 may kapartner na 2, 1. Ang 1, 3 may kapartner na 3, 1. 2, 3 may kapartner na 3, 2. So, this is symmetric. Is this transitive? Actually, pagka universal relation, nandun lahat. Yes, it is transitive. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 2, 1, 2. Yan, meron lahat yan. Okay. Question is this anti-symmetric? Hindi. Bakit? Again, meron itong mga kapartner na kasymmetric niya. But remember, 1, 2 is 1 is not equal to 2. Okay. Now, for the last one, empty relation, wala daw naman. By default, itong special case ito, by default, this is reflexive, symmetric, transitive, and anti-symmetric at the same time. Kasi wala namang laman eh. Okay? So, imagine nyo, wala, okay, as in kawalan. No? Reflexive ba siya? Wala namang laman eh. Symmetric ba siya? Yes, kasi kung imi-mirror niya sa rin, kawalan pa din naman eh. Transitive, wala, 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 wala. Then, wala. Okay? So, special case ang empty relation natin. Okay? So, that's it for our activity 4. For the others, it might take time for you to process this. So, please review. And again, you can look for Trev Tutor or Neso Academy for these lessons on discrete mathematics. Okay? So, yun lang. And please do expect a new lesson next week, a continuation of this. Okay? So thank you so much and I'll be seeing you next time. Bye!